Yo, what's up guys? Welcome back to the channel. My name is Kevin Pack. I'm a six-figure Amazon seller. And in today's video, we're gonna talk about how much money do you really need to be starting an Amazon FBA business in 2020. So one of the main things that a lot of people are concerned about is how much money they're gonna really need, because starting up a business can be expenses and you can't just start up with no money. So let's get you prepared so that you know exactly how much money you're gonna need to start up your own Amazon business. Now the great thing is this time of day, it's a lot less expensive to start up an online business than a physical store business. Physical stores could take up lots of money and usually you gotta take out a loan to pay up for all that upfront cost. But with Amazon, it's online business, you could really just spend just a few thousand dollars to really start your business up of your own money and get things running. So that's one of the main reasons why I love e-commerce so much, is that the barrier of entry isn't too crazy up there. It's not like,
hey yo, drop $50,000 right now and then you can start your business.
Like no, you can start with just like a few thousand and then you should be okay. So before we get into it, let's check up on my sales. So today is December 23rd, it's a couple days before Christmas. So the holiday peak season is over. Man, it was crazy. It was insane, and I can't believe I did these kind of numbers. But things have slowed down now, and I've actually sold out of one of my best-selling products. So I only have one product live right now, but my best seller right now is out of stock and should be in stock this week. So my numbers are kind of low right now. So you can see right here. So it's 10 a.m. and we've done 3 sales so far, and in the past 30 days, if you can see in that reflection, I've done $112,000 in the past 30 days. So I'm super happy with how December has went. $112,000 in 30 days is freaking insane. So we'll see how things pick up once January comes along. But I want to show you guys that because I want you guys to know that I'm a current Amazon seller right now. And you're going to see all the ups and downs of my sales and everything like that, and what it's like to be a true online business owner. So without further ado, let's get to the numbers and talk about how much money you're gonna need. So one of the first things you're gonna need for sure is like softwares, okay? Softwares to do product research, find your winning product, okay? So things like that are gonna be like Jungle Scout, like I talked about in previous videos, Helium 10, and then later on you can get accounting softwares like Shopkeeper or Seller Board. But altogether, those monthly programs can cost anywhere up to a big whopping $150 a month in total. Next, moving on to inventory. Okay, so this part is where it gets super, super subjective based off of your goals and your needs and your product, okay? Whatever product you pick out. Some products are $1 per unit, some are $5 per unit. It really depends. So whatever your budget is currently, I mean, that's what you're gonna work around to find that right product. If you only have $1,000 in the bank, you're not gonna go find a product that's $10 per unit. Typically what I see and what I start off with is about 500 units to test out the market and see how I go. 500 units is for markets that are making like over at least $6,000 a month, okay? In revenue, not profit, but in revenue. Those are usually what I see, and it's items that are usually in between the $15 to $25 range. So those are my type of products and what I would source. So my goal into it would be, if I source a new product, I would want a product that's making me at least an additional $2,000 in profit and like $5,000 to $6,000 in revenue minimum. So with that being the case, you want to figure out what your goal is so that you know how much you want to spend. So if you want to make the same thing as me and make an extra couple thousand dollars a month, then you're gonna need to realize that your inventory is probably gonna cost that same amount, $2,000 or $3,000 up front for that first initial investment. Chinese suppliers also have minimum order quantities, so you can't just order like 5 units from them or anything like that. You have to order big batches. So a lot of the times they will have a minimum order quantity of at least 300-400 units, and if you're considering the product is about, you know, $2-$3 per unit, I mean, you're gonna be looking at, I mean, at least probably about $1,000, close to $1,000 minimum just for inventory alone. That does not include shipping. Shipping alone can be an additional $1,000. So for the total cost of the product, you're looking at possibly already $2,000. So you can plan for about, I suggest $2,000 for your initial batch of inventory, your first batch. Now there's a lot of people out there in YouTube videos saying,
oh, you can start with $500 or just $1,000.
But that's bullshit, because you still have to consider your softwares that you use, shipping. You have to consider how much photography and advertising are. So instead of lying to you guys and saying, oh, it's so easy just to start off for $500, fuck that bullshit. You're gonna need way more than that. So not only do you need that $2,000 just for that inventory plus shipping, but you need an additional $2,000 ready in case this batch of inventory sells out really quickly. You need to order it again up front so you don't run out of inventory, because Amazon doesn't pay you right away as soon as you make a sale. They pay you every 14 days, and if you're a new seller, it can take 3 weeks because you have to wait 7 days after the product has been received by the customer for you to receive your payment. So in total, that can be like 3 weeks until you get your first paycheck, basically. But after that, after it's consistent, then it would be every 14 days, every 2 weeks, basically. But because of that delay, you don't have your money ready. And say, let's say your product is about to sell out in like 2 weeks, but you don't get paid in 3 weeks. You need to have that money ready so you can order your inventory as fast as possible and get it there as soon as possible. So you can limit the amount of time you're sold out, because the longer you're sold out, the more money you have to spend to relaunch the product and get it back to the same sales. So you need your money for your first batch of inventory, and you need a backup of that same money for your second batch just in case. Photos. Okay, so photos can make or break a product. You want your photos to be like on point. I'm talking about fashion model, Nike footwear looking type of pictures up in here, okay? They need to be crispy. There should not be any point of blurriness in your motherfucking photos, man. I'm telling you, it needs to be perfect. So I really recommend you go to a professional photographer that's local around you, so you can be there and direct how you want your photo and make adjustments. It'll be super, super faster and easier that way. If you can't do that, go on fiverr.com, hire a motherfucker up on there so they can send you some photos of your product, okay? Takes a little bit longer, but you'll probably get just as good quality as well. So photos, if you're gonna need like 6-7 photos at least. So that's probably going to cost you anywhere between $300 and $500 right there. Now, next up is listing optimization. Now, you could do this a few different ways. Well, for keyword research, you already have Helium 10 to do that, and you're already paying for that. But if you want to do your own copyright, which means typing out your features and details of the product, you can do that yourself. I personally like to do it myself, but then have a professional copyright person rewrite it for me, or just kind of overview and make adjustments on there. You can go on Fiverr and do that as well. It could cost anywhere between $25 and $60 right there. All right, and finally, the last one is PPC. Okay, PPC, pay-per-click advertising. Now, this one's a little bit of a weird thing, because when you use Amazon PPC, you don't get charged right away. You get charged when you meet a certain threshold. So like, if your threshold's at $500, they'll charge you once you reach that $500. You don't get charged right away. When they charge you, they can either charge it from your account, your Amazon account. And so if you've already made sales and made money, then they'll just subtract it from whatever it is. So you don't really pay out of pocket for anything. But you can also do it on a credit card as well, or a separate bank account. You could do a charge card on there, and then they will directly take money out of there instead, okay? But your paycheck from Amazon would be bigger because they're not taking money from there. So it could go either way, but there's not really a specific amount of PPC spend. I would say just keep a safety budget of like $1,000 ready, just for a cushion in case you don't have any sales, and then they charge your card right away, or charge your account right away. But if you're making sales, you're gonna end up not using that $1,000, because you make sales, you spend, you make sales, you spend, and boom. That's a good situation right there. There you go, right there. So you got about $2,000 for inventory, another backup $2,000, that's $4,000. You got your photos, which could be anywhere between $300 and $500. So that's looking at like $4,500. And then on top of that, you got your softwares, which could be another $150 right there. And finally, your ad cushion, which is another $1,000. So in total, I'll put up the number. I'm not even doing math in my damn head right now, but that's the total number that you typically is about a range of what you would need to start up your Amazon business and actually make good sales. I'm not talking about making like an extra like $200 a month or $500. I'm talking about like at least over $1,000, because we want profit, guys. If you're only gonna put a little bit of money, you're not gonna make much money back out of it. The more money you put in, the more money you're gonna get out of it. With what I'm kind of, what I normally see and what I've experienced myself, that's kind of what I've spent. And I've been able to make an extra $1,000, $2,000 in profit, and then scale that up further from there to where I have it now, okay? So that's really it, guys. Thank you so much for watching. If you have any questions or comments or anything like that, go ahead and leave it in the comments below. And if you haven't subscribed already, hit the subscribe button if you guys want to see more Amazon videos and lifestyle entrepreneurship videos. Stay tuned for that. And then if you haven't already, of course, smash that like button right there, okay? So thank you guys so much for watching. Go ahead, get that money, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.